So hopefully you're joining this tutorial because you're working with Python or you want to work with Python and you want to create a new virtual environment. In this tutorial, I'll take you through the steps of creating a virtual environment in a Windows environment. Now here we're using Windows 11, but this process that we go through in this tutorial should work with Windows 11, 10 and Windows 7. The first step here is to download Python. Now, if you're not too sure if you have Python installed already, you can just press the start button and the start button on your keyboard, or just go to start and use the search and open up the command prompt. Within the command prompt, you can type in py and then dash dash version, and that should then give you or tell you the version of Python that's installed. Here you can see that Python isn't installed. I'm receiving this py is not recognized as an internal or external command. Therefore, I need to now go ahead and install Python. It's a pretty straightforward process. Just type in Python download in your browser and then go over to the Python website. Here it should detect what versions of what operating system you have. And you can just go ahead and just click the button here. It says download. If you want a specific version, you can just drill down in the downloads. Select Windows, your operating system, and then you can select the different version you want to use. So if you do that, we've gone into Windows. We're just going to download Python 3.10.2, but we're going to download the 64-bit version if you like, or in this case, sorry, the Windows installer 64-bit. So just go ahead and do that and go ahead and just go through the installation process at this stage, at this point in 2022. You should just be able to click next, 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 and that should just take you through the process. We'll go through the process because it's not installed in this machine very quickly. So here is just a case of adding Python to the path and then just press install now. And that's pretty much all you need to do at this point. And just go ahead, install that, maybe restart the machine afterwards, and then that should be Python installed. Once Python is installed, it will say setup was successful. You don't actually need to restart at this point. We can disable the page, the path limit if we like. We can give that a go. And that might not appear on yours. Here I'm using a virtual machine. So next up, let's go ahead and just download Visual Studio Code. So just again, type that into Google. Go ahead and just download the version, the Windows version. That will then download. And just again, press next, next, next to install or install it wherever you want to install it. And then we can start the process of creating a virtual environment. So go ahead and open that file that's downloaded. And then you just need to accept the license agreement. Press next, 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 and next, and then install. And there we have Visual Studio Code installed. So now we have all the tools ready. I'm not going to launch just now. I'm just going to close everything down. So before we start a project in Visual Studio Code, we are going to need a new folder. So on my desktop, wherever you want to put it, I'm just going to create a new folder. I'm just going to call this example. And then I go ahead and I'll start Visual Studio Code. I can press the start button and then just type in Visual Studio Code. It should appear in my list. So we need to ensure that we know where we're actually going to put the virtual machine. Now, generally working with Python, you may put the virtual machine in, say, project folder. So let's go ahead and go to File, Open Folder, and then we're going to open the folder that we just created on the desktop. That was, it's not there. Desktop, Example, Select Folder. So let's just trust the author. It's just an empty folder. So we have an empty folder here at the moment. Right, so next step then is for us to open up the terminal down here. So you can see that I dragged from the blue line up. There is a shortcut for that. And you can see that here, if you go to view and terminal. So the shortcut here to open up terminal is control plus. So that will open up and close the terminal. Else just drag up. Right, so the first thing I'm going to do here then, let's just go ahead and type in py again, dash dash version. That should show the current version of Python that's currently installed. So this time you can see we are told that we've installed Python 3.9.10. So I've just zoomed in here so we can see this in a little bit more detail. So now we know Python is installed. Let's type in CLS to clear that. So now we're going to create a virtual environment. So here we're going to type in py for Python, and then we can use the m flag to tell Windows that essentially we're going to run an executable, if you like, and then that's we're going to run venv. And now we need to decide where we want to place our venv. So here we're just going to specify a folder, and then that's going to be placed here in this directory. Notice that we are working within this directory here, our working directory. That's the default directory that's been added here in our terminal. When we create a new folder, or when we start a, when we open a new folder, our terminal just automatically works from in that folder. So here I'm going to type in venv. This is the name of the folder. So I press enter, and then that's going to take a couple of seconds, and you can see that we have a new folder called venv. So now we have our virtual environment ready. We now need to start it. So here we need to type in venv. Now I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to type in v, and then I'm just going to press tab, and then that should just find the folder here for me and add all the other components that are needed. And now I need s and tab, and then a and tab, and then press enter. So that's going to activate the virtual environment. Now notice here it says there's a problem. This is a fairly common problem that appears or you might have on your computer. So I'm going to just take you through this process here. There is a few ways of doing this in actual fact, and I'll leave this link in the video description so you can have a look at some other commands. Now this sometimes does depend whether you can access the machine as administrator or not. So depending whether you can do that, that might depend on what command you use. But ultimately what you're going to need to do here is, if you just go into start, let's open up the PowerShell. So Windows PowerShell. That's going to open up a PowerShell, and we're going to be able to type something in here. Oh. And then we're going to type in one of these commands. So here I'm going to use set execution policy and so on. So we're going to run that, and then it's going to ask me a question. Here I'm going to type in Y for, oh, sorry, I'm going to type in A for yes to all, and then press enter. And then once I've done that, I just need to close the PowerShell. Let's go back to our Visual Studio Code. You're going to need to close that and restart it. So Visual Studio Code. Now it will remember where you left off. It normally does. So I've not put the opened the right one up. That's why. So just go back into start. Visual Studio Code. So like I said, it should remember where we left off. Yep. Okay. So now we've done that, we should be able to run the command again to start our virtual environment. So let's give that a go again. So I can just press up, and that would take us back to the previous commands. And you can see the previous command here was our activation of our virtual environment. So we give that a go. And then this time you can now see, just clear that. You can now see we've started our virtual machine because it's indicating that here with these green parentheses with the word venv within it. So now we're working inside the virtual environment. So we can go ahead and disable this. And the quickest way to do that is just to press the bin button here, and that will just kill the terminal. So if I did that and then just opened up a terminal again, you can see that we are currently outside of the virtual machine again because we don't have venv. So that's just one way of killing it. But we can also deactivate. So here we just deactivate. That will then deactivate the virtual environment if we're inside of it. So we can alternatively just deactivate it via the script here. So let's just go back and activate it again. And there we go. If you do have any problems with this, I do definitely want to help you out as much as possible. This is such a this can make or break whether you decide to use the language or not, because people can spend hours trying to fix these little problems here. So please drop a message in the comments and I will look out for them specifically, and I will help you if you get stuck at this point. So thank you again for watching if you have got this far, and I hope to see you in another tutorial.